Hi, I'm Zor. Welcome to Unizor Education. Today we will talk about differential, not differentiating, which is basically finding the derivative, but what is differential of the function. Well, this lecture is part of the course of advanced mathematics, which is presented on unizor.com for teenagers and for high school students. It's basically a very comprehensive and advanced course, which contains many problems, because I consider actually solving problems as the main point actually of studying mathematics. All right, so, and by the way, the site is free and it has certain functionality, like taking exams, for instance. Okay, differential. Well, let me start first from the definition of the derivative, which we are familiar with. So we take a point, x0, make some kind of an increment of the argument, and take the difference between value of the function at incremented value of the argument and original value, and divide by increment and leave it as this increment goes to zero. So that's the definition of the function, and we assume that this limit exists, so the function is smooth, differentiable, and whatever else. Now, there is a very important notation. Which is attributed to Leibniz. It looks like some kind of a division. And at the end of this lecture, I will tell you why this is justified, basically. Okay, so let's examine basically what this is all about. Well, first of all, this limit makes the whole formula a little bit more, I would say, involved, too bulky, if you wish. And mathematicians prefer to have as short notation as possible. So, in this particular case, delta x is basically implied as some kind of a variable, which is converging to zero. Now, if we do not use the limit here, then it would be just a particular fixed value of delta x, and that would be a particular value of difference of the function divided by difference of the argument, and this is not a derivative, right? It's some kind of a concrete value, which obviously depends on the point x0, our base point which we started from, and it also depends on delta x. So, the first step towards simplification of this formula, so to speak, is to imply this limit. So, it's not like we are saying, okay, we don't have limit, but we kind of assume this is a limit. But we would like to have another notation which implies that some kind of a increment of the argument is not actually a concrete number, but a variable which is converges to zero. And the invention was, instead of using delta x, use dx. Now, in some way it's the same thing, but at the same time you have to understand that if you are using this particular notation for increment, you actually assume that it's not just any increment, it's a process of increment converging to zero. You can consider it as a sequence which is going to a zero, or you can consider it as a function of time, and as the time goes by, this is becoming smaller and smaller. So this is an infinitesimal variable. Now this is a concrete increment, and without the limit, it's really just a particularly fixed number. This is an infinitesimal variable. That's very, very important. And if we are using this, we actually can skip the notation limit here, because it's assumed in this notation that this is what it is. So that's number one. Now, number two, let's just write it down a little bit differently. F of x 0 plus, well, I will use dx right now, if you don't mind. Minus f of x divided by dx. Now we are assuming that dx is an infinitesimal variable, right? So basically we are talking about this limit. So what is this? Is this a derivative at point x0? No, because this is an infinitesimal variable, and this is the difference between two infinitesimal variables. So it's some kind of a variable. This is a number, so we cannot put equal sign among them, right? So what I have to do, I have to add an infinitesimal variable. So we assume that this limit exists, right? Which means that this thing is actually equal to its limit plus infinitesimal variable, because that's actually the meaning of the limit, right? If this is a limit of this, so this is equal to limit plus infinitesimal. So the difference between them is supposed to be infinitesimal variable, right? Okay. Now let me rewrite it slightly differently. F of x 0 plus dx minus f of x 0, it's supposed to be 0 here, equals to f of x 0 times dx plus epsilon times dx. Now, what is interesting here is that this is a difference between two values of the function at point x0 and at incremented point dx, x0 plus dx. Now, and this difference is, supposed to be derivatives. Now, this difference is actually, bulk of it is proportional to the increment of the argument, right? And the coefficient of proportionality is the derivative at point x0. Now then, there is a little bit extra. And what is this a little bit extra? Now, we know that dx is an infinitesimal variable. Derivative is a constant. So this is of an order of dx. How about this? Well, don't forget that dx is infinitesimal, but epsilon is also infinitesimal, which means that the whole member is of the order little o of dx. I hope you remember this notation. It means it's an infinitesimal of a higher order of decreasing. It goes to zero faster than just dx. Why? Because dx goes to zero and epsilon goes to zero. So they are independent, two independent variables. And that's why this can be considered as a major component of this difference. And this is considered to be an infinitesimal of a higher order than this one. This is of an order dx. This is of an order infinitesimal epsilon times dx, which is a higher order of decreasing of infinitesimal variable. So this is the major component, this is a minor component. Okay, we've done that. Now let me put some kind of a graphic of the function and illustrate this graphically. So let's assume that this is your function. Now this is x0. This is x0 plus dx. And again, we're assuming that there is certain process when this point is getting closer and closer to this point, because dx is infinitesimal variable. Now, what is derivative at point x0. Well, that's actually the tangent of the tangential line, right? Now, this is f of x0. This is f of x0 plus dx, right? Okay, this is dx. Let's put points A, B, C, D, E. Okay? Now, so the difference between this point and this point, AB, is actually dx, right? This is a dx, our increment. AC is function of x0, and BE is function of x0 plus dx. Now, this is f. Now, what is EF? EF is the difference between incremented value of the function and its original value at this point. So this is actually let me just change my pen. Of x0 plus dx minus function value of x0, right? That's what EF is. Now let's look at this. So this is EF. Now what is this? It's dx times the derivative at this point. Dx times tangent of this angle between tangential line and horizontal line of this angle, if you wish. So this is basically df, right? So what's interesting is that on the left of this is ef. On the right, there is a df plus something. And this is something ed, which is epsilon times dx. Now, what's interesting is as this point B is getting closer and closer to A, my DF segment and EF segment are actually getting closer and closer to each other, and the difference between them, ED, is an infinitesimal of a higher order than each of these guys. So that's what it means. Now, this is something which I would say delta f of x, point x0. Df is, by definition, is a differential of function f at point x0. So this is a definition. So this piece, which is almost the same as this one when our points are getting closer and closer. And this is a major component of increment of the function. So this major component is called a differential. So this is a differential of a function at point x0. So what is the differential? It's not a function, because it contains, obviously, x0. X0 can be anywhere, so it's kind of a function of x0, but it's also a function of dx. And dx is a variable, which is a completely different thing. So it's basically a function of two things. Initial point, where the whole thing is basically considered at x0, and an infinitesimal increment of this. So that's what differential of the function is. It's a product of differential of the argument, which is an infinitesimal variable, with coefficient of proportionality equals to the derivative at this particular point. So that's how we are approaching this concept of differential. Differential of the function is a major component of its increment. So EF is an increment, DF is a major component of the increment. And that's what differential is. Now, why is it better to deal with differential in many cases than with the increment of the function? Well, increment of the function is kind of a difficult thing, because you have to really compute the value of the function in two things, right? So it depends explicitly on how big your increment actually is. The differential depends only on the value of x0, because dx is any variable which goes to zero, actually, any infinitesimal variable. So what's most important actually is, in the differential, is obviously this coefficient of proportionality, which is a derivative. And this component is just any infinitesimal variable which goes to zero. It can be, for instance, a sequence 1 second, 1/3, 1/4, 1/5, etc., 1nth. It can be. It doesn't really make any difference from the differential standpoint, because any variable which is converging to zero can play the role of dx. The coefficient of proportionality is obviously the most important thing. So this thing is called a differential at point x0. Well, now you can probably skip the zero, because it doesn't really matter. Zero can be anywhere, right? So we can just skip this thing. And now it's quite justifiable to write, this is also zero, to write something like this, that f derivative of x is equal to differential of the function divided by differential of the x, right? So we divide this by this. So this actually justifies this Leibniz notation. It actually can be considered as a division if you understand what differential of the function actually is. Because differential of the function is always proportional to the increment of the argument. And the coefficient of proportionality is exactly this type of a thing. So whatever you choose, you can define derivative first and differential from there, or you can start from differential as a linear component of the increment of the function, and then go to the derivative. It doesn't really matter. But anyway, these are conceptual ideas behind a differential of the function. Now, let me do a little bit, it's a recollection of something which we have already covered before. Let me just remind you that we have covered something which is called a Taylor's series. Now, let me just remind you that function, let's say x is incremented value from x0, so it can actually be represented as a value of x0 plus first derivative at x0 times x minus x0 divided by 1 plus second derivative at point x0 x minus x0 squared divided by 1.2 plus etc. And the common member would be f nth derivative at point x0, x minus x0 to the power of n divided by n factorial, etc. It's an infinite series. So this is a Taylor's series. We have covered this at one particular lecture before. And I would like you to look at this. Well, obviously, x minus x0 can be changed to delta x, in which case you would have x plus delta x is equal to x f at x0 plus f at x0 delta x divided by 1 plus etc. So what's important here? That, let me make another transformation. This minus this is equal to, all right? So this is a Taylor's series, basically, or a little bit transformed Taylor's series. It basically tells you exactly the same thing as I was just talking about, that increment of the function has certain major component where the increment of the argument is proportional to this increment. Well, increment of the function is majorly proportional to increment of the argument, with the coefficient of proportionality being a derivative, plus something which is delta x squared, delta x cubed, etc., which are little o of delta x, right? Because they're all starting from delta x squared. Obviously, they're all infinitesimals of higher degree of decreasing, right? So all of these are decreasing much faster to zero than this one. So this is actually a major component, and this is just another justification for considering this to be a major component of this. And that's why, again, it's called the differential of the function at point x0. Okay, so that's just another kind of a considerations which basically give us exactly the same thing. So let's just talk again about the difference between increment and the differential. Increment is a concrete number. Differential, like this one, where delta x is a concrete number, right? By the way, it's supposed to be zero. Now, when we're talking about differential is an infinitesimal variable, always. So it's a process of converging to zero. Question is, how is it converging to zero? Okay, the differential of the function is converging to zero proportionally to infinitesimal variable of increment of the argument. So it's differential, it's not an increment, it's basically a process, it's a limit, if you wish, is implied. And the coefficient proportionality is first derivative. So what you can actually derive from this is that increment of the function divided by differential of the function at this point, if limit of the argument goes to zero, this is what? This is basically this, right? Now, obviously, you can just reduce this and you will get 1. In limit, this is negligible relative to this. So whenever you divide by delta x, as it goes to 0 is the same as dx, right? Dx is implied, actually, that delta x is going to 0. and this thing is an infinitesimal of the higher order than dx, so it gives the infinitesimal as a result. So we have 1 plus infinitesimal, and since it's a limit, it's just 1. So this is very important that the on the graph again, let me just do a little graph here. So if this is delta f, but if you have a tangential line on this side, you have df, because it goes proportionally to dx. So the ratio between this and this is getting closer and closer to 1 as we approach, as this point is converging to this point. Because the difference between them, which is basically encompassed here, is a higher order infinitesimal, which we can just disregard. So this is basically about what is differential. For whatever reason, I don't know why, I myself had certain problems in the beginning to understand the conceptual meaning of that differential. So what actually differential of the function is? Well, again, you should consider it in a limit kind of a reasoning approach. It's a variable which is converging to zero, and this converging is implied in the word differential, so you don't have to use the word limit, etc. So basically that's it for today. I do suggest you to read everything, whatever I said about differentials on the website on unizor.com. You just go to calculus and derivative, and then there is a differential topic. It might just, you know, put a little bit more light into whatever you've heard right now. Other than that, that's it for today. Thank you very much and good luck.